I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
Welcome back to my channel. I'm doing my session on my big ring light today because my kids took the little one. So I have to actually face a different direction because y'all know this is my favorite spot is being in the bed. And I really don't feel like setting this up in another room. So I like shooting in here because I normally like the background that I have with the chest. But today we're shooting this way. Look like I could still see a chess piece in the background, so let's just make it work with that. So this week I spoke with my surgeon and my oncologist, and my oncologist decided he wants to push the reconstruction back a little bit until after I finish the chemo pills. And I don't know how I feel about that, only because I want to get this surgery done before the end of the year, because I've already met my deductible with my insurance and I want to do it this year so I don't have to come out of pocket with anything else. But it's completely up to the oncologist what they're going to do. He's going to talk to my surgeon. They're going to come up with a game plan, and then we'll know then when we're going to do the reconstruction. Now, if you guys don't recall, the reconstruction is to remove the implants that I have here. They're going to take some fat out my stomach and replace the implants with the fat out my stomach. And my breasts, they're going to be about this size. So they might be like a C right now. I don't know what they are. But so we'll see when we get that. We'll cross that bridge then. I wanted to go over everything that's been going on this week. So we are going to start off with all of the markings, the blemishes, or whatever the heck they are. We're going to start with the ones in my head. I have been experiencing some hair loss, but it's only been around the perimeter. My forehead used to start like right here, but now it's starting like back here after whatever hair loss is going on here. Now, I don't think that this hair loss is from the chemo. We think that it may have something to do with stress and my hormones, because my hormones have definitely been out of whack for the past couple of months. So we have that. We got this, which in the camera it probably looks like a mustache. But you can see that I have those rashes like right here above my lip. So I put Aquaphor up here and then also on my lips too, because my lips have been getting black. You guys know about the tongue. I've gotten a couple of mouth sores this week, but the medicine that they gave me this time, whatever they use, I forgot what it's called, but I know it has a lot of cane in it where I swish it around my mouth. And it actually does stop the pain. It does stop the mouth sores in like 2 days. So whenever I even feel anything coming in my mouth, I go start doing the mouthwash. Of course, you guys already know about these black spots that are popping up all over my body and my face. You guys already know about this, which people ask me about this all the time. Like, what happened? And I tell my dear radiation. Of course, the port is still in. I did speak with my surgeon, and he said that they can remove the port at any point, but it's up to my oncologist. So I need to talk to him about getting the port removed. So hopefully I don't have to do any other kind of IV chemo. Also have these markings on my arm. They look like rashes. I talked to my doctor about it, but he act like it's normal. I guess y'all can see that. And most important, I am getting darker, and look at my hands. I did just put cream on my hands. The Aquaphor is what I'm using. As you can see, my hands are blistering up. The same thing is happening with my feet. So, no, yeah, I think y'all should be able to see that. My hands are super black. And my feet are super black. I don't want to show y'all my feet because my feet are really blistered up. I have not been able to do the 30-minute walk like I said I was going to do, because the very first day that I did it, my feet were absolutely killing me for like the next 3 days. And when I say they were killing me, like, I couldn't walk. That's how bad it was. So I was laid up in the bed for like 3 days. I did talk to my oncologist, and he did say that that is normal. My thing is, I can't fix none of this stuff that's going on. It sucks, because y'all know I'm a control freak, but I have placed everything in God's hands. And to keep reminding myself about that, every time I get stressed out or I start thinking about something, I say, God, I already put it in your hands. And then I try to switch the topic and move on to something else. God, I already put in your hands. I do want to let everyone know that whoever goes through this, and if you haven't gone through this, if you know somebody that goes through this, yeah, please be their major support system. Because that is the only way that they're not going to go insane. Support system, support system, support system. I tell y'all that probably on every video. You have to be able to assist your family and friends with this process. My children have been doing amazing. One of my kids missed the bus yesterday because I was so sick I didn't wake up on time to get him up. But when I did get up, he was here and he was helping me with my medicine. He asked me if I took my medicine, and I hadn't taken it. And so he grabbed all my medicines and then put the, because he know that on Sundays, we normally put all the medicines together to start off the week for Monday. Y'all, that take a process. That takes a long process to put that medicine together. Because you have to do it. Like, it's so many pills. It's just so many pills. But we got that together, so I took my medicine. And then this week, I'm not on the chemo pills. So it's not as, it is important to take the other meds, but I absolutely make sure I don't forget the other ones. But of course, I turned my alarms off this week because I knew I didn't have to take the chemo pills. I have to take those at the exact same time every day when I take them. So the other pills, I can take them after I get up and eat and things. But since I've been feeling sick, I've been in the bed, so I haven't been taking my meds. Until my son reminds me or asks me if I took it. This week was a pretty rough week. It was very hard for me walking. I did speak to my oncologist, and they did get me, I guess, an application to get my handicap sticker. Because y'all, it's to the point, like, if my feet hurt, baby, I can't do nothing. I will stay in the bed all day. Today they feel pretty good. I've still been in the bed all day, but that's just because I'm not feeling well. Been having some stomach issues. My throat has been hurting. I feel like I have a sinus infection. Y'all know that my immune system is going back down because I am on the chemo pills, so it is easier for me to get sick again, and that's part of the reason why I don't really go anywhere. I'd rather just stay at home. And then also now with the kids being in school, I kind of just stay in my room because I know that they are, of course, they're not doing COVID like they were. If you catch COVID now, they're just telling you throw a mask on. I cannot afford to get sick anymore, as far as my body is concerned, because when I get sick, then I get really sick. So that's why I hope, like, whatever I got going on right now, I really just think it's something that's passing through with the chemo. But I try to stay isolated. And I know that's not good, but when I do go out, I'm gonna go out and have fun or something. I found this paper. It was in a notebook. I was going through my desk. I had moved my desk and everything. So I was going through a notebook, and it looks like this is dated for August 26th, I'm assuming. It says first chemo treatment recap. So I'm gonna go over this list that happened in like August last year, and we're going into August. We're on August 28th this year. So I'm kind of, almost the timeline is almost exact of me doing IV chemo compared to me doing the chemo pill, literally like almost a year later. So black dots on the face, check. We know I have that issue right now. Hands and feet have darkened, check. We know I have that issue right now. Skin starts peeling on feet, check. We know that I have that. I guess I can go ahead and show y'all what it looked like. It looked ugly, but I'm just gonna go ahead and show it to y'all. Y'all, my feet looks terrible. Like, ugh. It's blistering up. It's so bad. And they hurt. Like, my feet are super black. Like, look at it. And look at the color of my skin. Like, if you look at this angle, you can see what color my skin is. Like, look at my arm. And then look at my hand and feet. So, it's definitely getting there. I said I would never show y'all my feet. But I done showed y'all my feet twice. And they just look like my brother's feet. But, let's go to the next part. Skin starts peeling on feet. We got that. You see the blisters. That's on my hand and feet now. Facial hair loss. I don't think I'm experiencing any facial hair loss. I think just this part. And again, like I said, I think it's hormones. My hormones are out of whack. But I don't feel like wearing a wig. It's too hot outside. And not only that, I don't think I want to cover this up with all these black spots and stuff. So if y'all see me walking around here looking like a bald-headed scallywag, mind your business. Nails and toes turn black. I don't know if my actual nails have turned black because I got acrylic on right now. And then I got gel on my toes, so I don't know if they're black. And I don't want to know if they're black. That's why I got them painted. weight loss has been up and down by 10 pounds. Man, I'm not losing no weight and I'm not gaining no weight. I start trying to eat healthier, and I lost maybe like 2 or 3 pounds in the past 2 weeks. But then, I don't know. I can't make it a healthy life change yet because that's not an excuse, but this is the real reason. When they told me that I couldn't have my surgery, I'm like, you gotta be freaking kidding me. But I gotta lose the weight, y'all. I have to lose the weight. I gotta do it on my own schedule. I gotta do it on my own time. So we'll get there. I've been looking at people on Facebook and other like TikTok and stuff, how they're losing weight. So I'm gonna try a couple different things and then see what I can do. Cause I definitely gotta lose some weight. blood work done every week. Right now I get blood done bi-weekly. Bi-weekly doctor visits, still get bi-weekly doctor visits, bi-weekly chemo sessions. Okay, so with the chemo now, the chemo pill, I take the pills for 2 weeks on and 1 week off. And I keep repeating the cycles. So this Monday coming up will be the third cycle of the chemo pills. And we're going to be doing that for a couple months. I don't know when that's going to end, whenever they decide. headaches and extreme fatigue. I have been having a couple of headaches, but not a lot. Extreme fatigue, definitely, because I'll go to take a nap for like 2 hours, and then it'll turn to like 3 or 4 hours, even after I set an alarm. My body is not what it used to be, like internally. So I just have to get my rest. I do not really get upset, but I do have a problem with staying in the bed all day because I feel like I'm not getting nothing accomplished, but I'm supposed to be resting. That's something I'm going to have to figure out myself. Next week, I'm going to try yoga and Pilates. We'll see if that will help. I have to do something that's not stressful because my mom literally scared the shit out of me. And this is the second person that done told me this. My auntie told me this too last year, or probably this year. I don't know. It's all starting to be the same. That it's not going to be the cancer that's going to kill me. It's going to be the stress that's going to kill me because I'm a stressor and I don't know how to let things go. So I have to work on several different things on myself. So that's something that I'm working on. I have to try different methods because I am a stressor. I stress about everything. And y'all, I have to get it under control. Like, period. Like, I don't want to die anytime soon. So even though we are taking care of the cancer, we also have to take care of my blood pressure, my stress levels, and things like that. And I gotta get it together. Night sweats. I haven't been getting night sweats. So thank you, God. God, please don't let me get on night sweats because those are the worst. God, I'm asking and begging and praying to you. Please don't let me get on night sweats. Dizziness while standing. I haven't been dizzy while standing. So that's a plus. Inconsistent loss of taste. Y'all, my taste has been inconsistent for a while. The food doesn't taste the way it's supposed to taste. Like stuff that I know, like a restaurant that I've gone to where I know the food is supposed to taste good, it just does not taste the same. So I probably won't be eating out anytime soon. I've been mostly, cooking. Oh Lord, that's a hard word to say. Yeah, I've been having to do that. I hate cooking. Y'all never like cooking. I was always the businesswoman. I would go buy us food. I hate cooking, but I cook a whole lot more now. Maybe like 3 times a week. It's still not. What I try to do is fix enough food for the next day so I ain't got to cook the next day. And then carry on to the third day. Sometimes the leftovers go into the third day. And we just make it work. Make it work. This time around, I am doing more vomiting than just nausea. Last week I threw up like 3 times. I don't know why. I mean, I'll try to immediately take the nausea pill as soon as I feel it. So it's not something that I've been taking daily, but my doctor recommended that I start taking them daily. So that's another pill I'm going to have to add to my regimen is the nausea pill because it hasn't been just nausea. It's been vomiting. So that's the info I have for y'all for this week. Next week, I'm definitely going to shoot a video with my kids. I asked 2 of my kids already. And then the third one, she's a little bit harder to convince because she doesn't like being on video. But I do want to have a video with my kids in it to discuss how they felt when I was diagnosed and everything that they've gone through the past year or so. So that y'all can get their side of the story, y'all can get their understanding and what they have been going through. Because it doesn't just affect you, it affects your family members, your friends, and everyone around you. So I wanna try and get some of my friends at some point to talk about it too. I wanna get everybody's point of view because I want the people to know like what goes on in life when you have something like this going on. I still have not done my photo shoot because I haven't set it up. I'll probably set it up this weekend and one day this week when the kids get out of school, we'll do the photo shoot. I'm really skeptical about doing the photo shoot right now just because of what I got going on here. I don't like this at all, but I may be able to put some makeup on it to cover it up or something. But y'all, then it's going to look like I got an 8 head. I had a normal size forehead at first, but like all this stuff that's going on, I don't like this and don't like this at all. But we'll make it work. I think that's all I have. I'll get that video to y'all next week. And then I'll try to get more videos out than just me laying in the bed and then me in the car. Because that's the 2 places where I shoot my videos, mostly. I had a setup in my extra bedroom, but I ended up moving my son in that extra bedroom. So, I don't have all that stuff set up anymore. But the tote has been in the living room for like 2 weeks now that has the backdrops and my camera sitting right here. I fully charged it up like 2 weeks ago and we still haven't done the photo shoot. So again, I'm gonna try to do the photo shoot myself because I do photography, or did, let me rephrase, I haven't done photography in a while. But I still do it on the side. I'm probably gonna pick it up again if that means that it will help me get through this process. So, that being said, make sure that you guys like and subscribe to my channel, Verafied Visions. And guys, make sure that y'all share these videos. I want y'all to share these to get this information out. Thank you so much for your time, and y'all have a blessed weekend.